Hey everyone, today we will talk about how to design a ride hailing service. So let's get started. Let's talk about functional requirements. The system should allow users to see nearby available cabs with ETA at source. User should also be able to broadcast cab request to nearby drivers. User and driver should be able to see each other's location once ride is accepted. Driver should also be able to accept or decline a cab booking request and start and end the ride as well. User should be able to track this ride from source to destination once ride gets started. Now let's talk about non-functional requirements. The system should be having a very low latency. Also, the system should be highly available. Now, let's talk about designing the system. Let's say there are three drivers. One driver is available and free. The second driver is in ride. And let's say third driver is offline. All of these drivers are connected to driver side app API gateway via their app client. And let's say here we can omit driver service for the time being, assuming driver side clients are able to pull driver profile info from driver service and cache the data at device level. So let's say driver side clients starts pushing their locations and driver ID to location service every 5 second interval. And this keeps happening until driver sets them as offline. Also, location service maintains all active drivers' location at geohash level in cache. Now, what is geohash? Geohash primarily is a location encoding standard where length of geohash determines the cell size in the map. Okay. And this is how our sorted set for geohash level looks like. Primarily, geohash ID being a key, and in the sorted set, we can maintain a driver ID along with their last updated report. Okay. Also, we can maintain a hash where available driver ID can be a key, and for each key, we can maintain latitude and longitude as a last updated epoch time. Okay. Now, let's say there are a few users who are also connected to user app API gateway. Okay. And again, we can omit user service here, assuming user side clients are also able to pull user profile information from user service and cache this data at their device level. Okay. Now user starts sending, let's say, their current location and user ID to ride booking and ETA service at every 3 seconds whenever a user comes online on the app. And this keeps happening until app gets closed. And this is being done to primarily to understand and see all nearby available cabs live. Okay. So this ride booking service maintains all active ride statuses in the cache and can also use some sort of ride matching rules if required from database. Okay. Now, ride booking service receives the request from user and ride booking service now calls location service primarily to get available nearby drivers based on the user location. Okay. Then it computes ETAs on top of it and finally sends back the list of driver IDs and their locations along with the least ETA to the user. Okay. Now, let's say at some point of time when user is happy with the ETA at source and user places a cab request to ride booking service, mentioning the user ID and destination. Again, ride booking service asks location service to provide updated list of nearby available drivers so that it could send a cab request to all of them.
Okay.
Now, this ride booking service notifies all active drivers, and once drivers are notified, one of these drivers need to accept the request within 30 seconds. Else, the request will get expired. Also, once a driver accepts cab request, other drivers need to see this request as cancelled.
Okay.
Now, let's say on receiving the ride request, at driver's side, some interested drivers might want to send acceptance to ride booking service. Now, ride booking service considers only first acceptance and updates ride status in ongoing active ride status cache.
Okay.
And again, notify other drivers that, hey, this ride is cancelled because someone has already accepted. Now, ride booking service also notifies both driver and user saying, hey, the ride has been accepted and probably you guys need to connect over WebSocket connection in order to share each other's location until the ride gets started. Okay, so this WebSocket connection is being maintained from ride accepted state till ride started state only. Okay, and now both driver and user can share their live location via this WebSocket connection. Driver client immediately changes the driver state from available to in ride. Okay, until the ride gets cancelled or completed. Okay, now once driver reaches the user location, driver starts ride by notifying ride booking service, which in turn updates the ride status in active ride status cache and asks location service to close the WebSocket connection between user and driver, if any, and start pushing the driver location stamps in driver location tracking message queue. Okay, and ride booking service also notifies ride tracking service via message queue saying, hey, now you need to start tracking ride for this particular ride ID by consuming driver location data from this particular message queue. And this should keeps happening until ride gets completed. Okay. Now, notification service also gets notified by ride booking service to consume driver location data from this message queue. And we need to notify user also about the route being followed continuously. So notification service will keeps consuming this data as well continuously from driver location tracking message queue, and will keep sending this to user as a ride tracking update.
Okay.
Now, once ride is completed, driver will send ride ended status to ride booking service so that it could notify ride tracking service and the user about the ride, that ride is being added.
Okay.
Ride booking service may also check wallet service or some other service to understand if auto payment deduction has happened, and then confirms the driver again back, hey, the ride has finished and probably you can change your status from in ride to available again.
Okay.
And this is how so far we have done designing this service. Now there's a concern. What if driver client or user client gets disconnected at some point of time during the ride? How we can ensure that driver client does not become available again for a new ride meanwhile, or user client does not lose the active ride data?
Okay.
How can we reconnect user and driver clients with ongoing ride automatically post failure without any data loss? How can we do that? We can solve this problem by ensuring every time a client comes online,
okay,
they need to call ride booking service to check if there's any ongoing ride mapped to them. If yes, ride booking service would ask location service to either create a websocket between driver and user in case the ride is accepted but not started, or start pushing driver locations data in driver location message queue. And ride tracking also needs to be notified to consume this data in case the ride has started but not completed.
Okay.
Cool. So this is how the complete system design looks for ride hailing service as of now. Let me know your feedback. Hope you did like this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.